Animal Crossing New Horizons can seem a little random with all the visiting characters, mystery island villagers, and even the infamous fake art from Red. It can even seem nearly unpredictable when Celeste or Red is even going to show up on your island. Hey guys, it's Phil, and welcome back to another Animal Crossing New Horizons episode. In this episode, we're going to cover some of the used-to-be unknown details about Red, Celeste, Flick, and all of the other random visiting characters, and we're getting started right now. If you're a big Animal Crossing fan and want to stay up to date on all the news, tips, tricks, and all other Animal Crossing related content, then be sure to subscribe to my channel. I've got a lot of great content that you'd like to watch. And besides that, it's free. So first off, I want to start this video by giving a huge thank you to the data miners in the Animal Crossing community. If it wasn't for people like them, then YouTubers like me wouldn't be able to make videos like this. I'll put all of their details in the description of this video. Alright, so for starters, the game schedules when the visiting characters are going to be on your island every Monday at 5 a.m. And this actually corresponds with the following week, but we'll get to that in just a bit. Also, a lot of these characters don't show up on your island until certain things are completed. So, as an example, Label won't show up until you have the Able Sister Shop up and running. So if you need help there, I'll put all the requirements for each of the characters in the comments area below. So for starters, there are a total of 12 visiting NPCs that will visit your island one day or another. You've got Sahara, the wandering camel that sells the mysterious rugs and wallpapers. You've got Kix, the traveling skunk that sells shoes and other awesome accessories. Leaf, the sloth-looking fella that's known for his rare flowers and shrubs. You've got Gulliver, the seagull from the Alien Origins that will sometimes appear passed out on your beach. Label or Label, one of the sisters of the Able Sisters, that travels around selling various fashion items. Red, the infamous liar, the jolly good art scammer. You've got CJ, the cat fisherman that'll buy your fish for a higher price. And Flick, the chameleon that buys your bugs for a higher price as well. There's also KK Slaughter, the guy that plays music in the plaza every Saturday. Daisy May, the turnip lady. She shows up every Sunday. And then you've got Wisp, the ghost genie that will literally and randomly show up some nights throughout the week. And then lastly, Celeste, the younger sister of Blathers that wanders your island during meteor showers and provides DIY recipes to you on each of her visits. Now, you're probably asking, when do each of these visiting characters visit your island? It can seem a bit random, but there is a little bit of science behind it. So let's look at it from a week's perspective. So you've got 7 days in a week, and out of that, 5 weekdays and 2 weekend days. So for example purposes, and I'm not saying that the characters actually show up on these days, but I'm just kind of walking you through it. It'll be different for most everyone. So I'm going to put the 12 characters in a few different groups. Group number one is the guaranteed to show up group, which is Sahara, Kix, and Leaf. And they're guaranteed to show up on your island 3 days out of the week. And for this example, we'll just say that they're going to show up every Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And then you've got KK Slaughter, who shows up every Saturday, guaranteed. And then you've got Daisy May, who shows up every Sunday, guaranteed. And then group number two, which I'm calling the random group, is Gulliver, Label, CJ, Flick, and Red. And they'll be randomly chosen for Thursday and Friday. So that means that you've got 2 out of the 5 that will be chosen for this week to show up on Thursday and Friday. The other 3 out of 5 that were not chosen are given priority for the following week so that they can be selected to show up on the next week's Thursday or Friday. And that basically leaves one character out of the loop, which would explain why some of us aren't seeing Red very often, because it could be more than 2 weeks before we saw him again. Now, I'm just picking on Red here, but it could be any of the characters, any of the 5 characters, out of group 2, the random group. And then we've got a third group, which we're calling the exceptions, because Wisp is completely random, and he doesn't have any dependencies on any other visiting character. And then Celeste, she doesn't have any dependencies on any other character either. However, she does only show up on meteor shower nights, and only during certain weather patterns. As for Celeste, I've got another video coming that goes into more detail about how you can predict her visits, but at a high level, she can only appear on certain weather pattern days. For example, there's only about 6 different main weather patterns, and she can only show up on one of those. The video that I've got coming soon will share a tool and all the instructions on how you can predict her showing up on your island, just by recording your weather patterns. Now, let's talk a little bit about Red's paintings, because I'm sure by now, just about all of us have been ripped off by his fake paintings. The second one that I bought was a complete fake, even though I actually thought it was real. Give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying this video and if you've been completely ripped off by Red before. Alright, so for Red, here's how this works. We have a total of 6 items that he will have each visit. 4 items will be art or sculpture items, and then the other 2 will be rare furniture items. So for the 4 art or sculpture items, here's how the odds play out if they're fake or if they're real. 10% of the time, there's going to be 1 fake and 3 real. Another 10% of the time, there's going to be 4 fake. That means you have 0% chance of getting a real painting or sculpture. And then another 30% of the time, there's going to be 2 fake and 2 real. And then 50% of the time, there's going to be 3 fake and 1 real. And then lastly, for each real item, there's a 20% chance that the game's going to guarantee you an item that you don't already have in the museum. So as you can see, there is always a possibility that you're going to get ripped off, and there's a 0% chance that all the items on that day are going to be real. As a matter of fact, you're more likely to get a fake item than you are a real item. So here's the really cool thing about all this information. Now that we know how the character rotation works, you can basically start to record for yourself when each character has showed up on your island. And by that information, you can start to predict basically when Red, Flick, and Celeste, and some of these others are likely to show up on your island. And that's it, guys. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Share it with your friends if it was helpful to you. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook, and come over to my Discord channel and say hey. Take a look at one of my other Animal Crossing how-to videos that are on the screen right now. And also, don't forget to check out my channel and subscribe.